When Migaku is activated for a specific video site, the toolbar will appear at the top of the page when you watch content. The first button on the left side of the toolbar shows the flag of the language you selected. If you want to change your language selection, you can click here. Next to the flag, you will find your known word count. To the right of your known word count, you can find your comprehension stats for the current video. When hovering over the comprehension stats, a more detailed breakdown of your stats for the current video opens. Here you can see your general comprehension, the number of recommended sentences, the average frequency of the unknown words on the page, and more. The general comprehension and the number of recommended sentences can also be found on the toolbar itself, next to the comprehension indicator. Clicking on the CC button allows you to access the video options. In Target Language Subtitles, you can select the subtitles of the language you are learning. Secondary subtitles is generally used for subtitles in your native language that will be displayed below the target language subtitles. The Show Secondary Subtitles drop-down menu allows you to select between four options. When Always is selected, the secondary subtitles will always be displayed. When on Hover is selected, the secondary subtitles will only be shown when you hover over them, otherwise they will be blurred. When If There Are Unknown Words is selected, the secondary subtitles will only be shown when there is an unknown word in a target language subtitle line. When Never is selected, the secondary subtitles will never be displayed. With the plus and minus button, you can increase or decrease the size of the subtitles. Subtitles can be completely hidden or shown again by selecting the option in this menu, pressing W or the upwards arrow on your keyboard. When Open Pop-up Dictionary on Hover is selected, no button has to be pressed to look up a word in the pop-up dictionary, as it can simply be opened by hovering over the word. When Pause on Subtitle Hover is activated, the video will automatically be paused when you hover over subtitles. On the right side, you can see all the available play modes. Default plays the video as normal. When Reading is selected, the video will automatically pause at the beginning of each subtitle line to give you time to read the line before you can press the space bar to continue playing the video and listen to what you just read. Recall mode, on the other hand, hides the subtitles while the video is playing and automatically pauses the video after each subtitle line to give you time to read the subtitle line and compare what you understood while listening with the actual subtitle line. Only Show Subtitles on Pause works as you would expect. When selected, the subtitles are always hidden until you pause the video. Pause on Recommended Sentences automatically pauses the video when a subtitle line contains a recommended sentence.
ねえ、お父様。 女学校に着ていく新しいお着物が欲しいのだけれど。
Skip mode allows you to fast forward through segments of no spoken dialogue in content you are watching. You can choose between 2 times, 4 times, 6 times, 8 times, and jump. When jump is selected, the video automatically jumps to the beginning of the next subtitle line after one line is finished. The I button opens the display options. Two of the basic settings that are available in every language are learning status and sentence on hover. When learning status is enabled, words will automatically receive their learning status underline. You can learn more about learning statuses in our learning status video. The sentence on hover option is not applicable on video sites. Beside these two options, you can also find language-specific settings. More on these options is available in the language-specific feature videos. At the bottom, by clicking on Show Advanced, you can open more advanced options. Currently, there's only one option available, compound lookups. We recommend activating this feature. The keyboard button opens the keyboard shortcuts to allow you to look them up as needed. By clicking on the subtitle browser button, the subtitle browser can be displayed or hidden. The same can be done with the shortcut G. The lock icon can be used to lock the toolbar in place. When unchecked, the toolbar hides after a few seconds. To make it appear again, simply click on the Migaku icon in the Grabby Tabby. It can also be repositioned along the top of your browser by clicking the three dots and dragging it left or right. When clicking the last button, the Migaku app window opens.